Hello there, how are you? Welcome back. Well, today's video, I am showing the first half of installing the mini split. The second half will actually be of me charging the system. Now, just know that I've already hung the brackets and the compressor outside 16 feet off the ground, and no, I do not have footage of that. It was quite a gong show. And the footage that was on that particular project was in my hard drive that I dropped and broke. And no, I still have not been able to get that data recovered. But with that being said, moving on, this is, well, two sets of scaffolding up. The ceiling peak is right at 16 feet. So getting this 4x8 sheet of drywall up there, it wasn't actually a true 4x8 sheet. As you can see, I cut down the gable angles on it. But it was a challenge. It was definitely a challenge. And the nice thing is that black band going across there, that beam has a little lip. So I was able to sit that drywall, kind of curl it right in there and sit it on that lip while I got it screwed in place. Once I was able to get that in place, it was just a matter of getting the dedicated electrical circuit installed. Well, it was already installed, put in back in place, and then getting the RV 12-volt exhaust fan open back up. Now, the nice part about this is when the weather's great, you want to just vent the nasty air out of the inside of the barn dominium. I'm doing air quotes here. You can just open that up. It's thermostatically controlled. I also have the switch on the wall that I can control the power to it. And the sound that you're hearing in the background is actually from the fan running, because it's pretty toasty out here without having air conditioning in this metal building. Some of the metal building, I've been able to get the insulation up. I do have footage on that coming up. Some drywall has been put in place. But again, I'm working by myself, so as you can see, it gets a little bit of challenging at times. Anyway, this part here, hang your bracket about where you want the actual unit to sit, and then your directions will be specific on where you're going to cut your hole. This hole is for your copper pipes from the interior unit, the electrical from your interior unit, and the drain pipe, the condensate pipe, to run from the interior unit. Gently, you know, straighten out your copper pipe. You don't want to try to do this super fast or at a hard bend. It will crimp it off, it'll destroy it, and then at that point you do the standby. Worst case scenario is you have to hire somebody. Anyway, I should have the, I don't know why, I think because it was so hot, for some reason I did not hook in the electrical wire that goes into the interior unit out to talk to the exterior unit. It just, I kicked myself in the butt because this created some pretty awkward work. If I had just done this down on the floor instead of being up here on the scaffolding, it was hot, hot, hot. I think it was like 92 degrees when I was trying to install this without having the air conditioning. So it was a challenge. It was definitely a challenge. The other thing is you want to remove the plastic cover off it so you can get to it to tie those electrical wires in. And it has this one last hidden screw that's behind a little thumb tab. You pull that down, you pull that screw out. And the nice thing is this plastic shroud that goes around the fan will just slide right off and make pretty easy work of it. So again, if I had done all of this down on the floor, I wouldn't be up here baking my brain. Maybe that's the problem. I don't know. Anyway, last screws out. Again, this just slides right off of there. And then it's a matter of going outside and feeding the doggone wire back through the hole to the interior unit. Now I did purchase, it's not a name brand GoPro, it's a knockoff, just because I was going to try to start giving y'all some better, more close-up footage of things that I'm doing. So the learning curve on this is, well, let's just say there's a pretty large learning curve, but eventually I will get this thing mastered for you. As you can see, I'm wearing it there. I was trying to do that so you could actually get some up-close footage, but I had the thing angled too doggone far back of my head, so I was just filming the wall. The best laid plan goes awry, right? It really doesn't matter anyway. When you install these mini splits, the beauty of it is each individual line wire that connects is the same on the inside as it is on the outside. So you just need to make sure that you match them up. If it's a blue wire, put the blue wire on the, say, the number one position, and when you go outside, put the blue wire on the number one position, and so on down the line. And I'm sure all of these mini splits are probably set up or designed the same exact way. Once you get your wires hooked up, and again, don't do like I did. I wanted this unit mounted up here to where it could flow across, cool down the loft area in the barn where the outside unit's at, and I'll go into more detail next week on that. But I wanted that unit blowing out the gable end window, so it kept the porch area of my barn dominium here a little bit cooler. On top of it, it keeps it in a shielded structure during hurricane season, or when I'm not here at the barn, I don't have to worry about somebody walking up beside the building and just taking my mini split and walking off with it. This is the unit put back together. There were four simple screws going across the top, and then that last little screw that I had to search and search and search for is right down here in the center. Put that back in, and it is all buttoned up and ready to go. Now I'm going to show this portion just one more time, only because this has to be unplugged in order to pull the plastic shroud off of there. The thing is pretty stiff, but it does just unplug, and then that whole plastic cover or shroud or case, whatever you want to call it, will come directly off. So once you plug it back together, put the electrical cover back over it, the interior portion is absolutely complete. Pretty simple, straightforward. This thing is absolutely blowing cold, working like a charm, and next week I will show you how I vacuumed the system down and the first startup. Have an absolutely wonderful and blessed day.